Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Life Form RB, and welcome to a new episode of Let's Play Spyro 2 Ripto's Rage for the PlayStation 1. In our last episode, we explored Metropolis, the last level of the game, and we now have all the orbs, all the gems, and all the talismans in the game. And it's finally time. There's only one thing in the game left for us to do.
Orbs. Defeat of Ripto is only moments away, right? Right? Well, anyway, good luck. He's right through this door.
Yep, that's right. I've kept you folks waiting long enough. It's now time for the final boss battle against Ripto. Let's not waste any time. Here we go.
Animals!
Hey, Shorty! Maybe I can help.
What? You again?
Yep. If you want to test that power crystal, why don't you try it on me? I'll stand still. I promise.
I like that idea. Dragon, you've just sealed your fate!
Oh, we shall see, Ripto. We shall see. All right, this is it. The final battle. Here we go.
Spyro, we want to help you fight Ripto. Elora is using the orbs you collected to store power-up energy. Hunter will throw the powered-up orbs to you as they become ready. Even as we speak, the professor is experimenting with new forms of power-up energy, so you'll soon have abilities that no one has ever seen before.
Sounds good to me. Anything that can help me get an edge in this fight. Alright, Ripto, you and me. This has gone on for long enough. It's go time, baby! Now, in this fight, your normal attacks do not affect Ripto. So, you're going to have to use the orbs that Hunter drops onto the battlefield to get power-up energy, but Ripto can use them as well. In fact, he's about to grab one before me. So the red power-up is a fire attack. Fire waves that Ripto can use. Ripto can also attack using his scepter. Now, if you get the blue power up, you'll do a supercharge that lasts as long as you hold down the square button, and as long as there is power up energy. Now, if you want to keep Ripto from getting to an orb, you can use the charge or flame to knock him backwards. Red power-up energy gives you a super flame type power-up, and I missed that orb completely. So I should point out, ladies and gentlemen, I have not even practiced this fight, so yeah, I'm probably gonna take a few hits. Mine! And this boss fight is in three phases, so this is gonna be a long one. Depending on how I do. That last hit was for good measure, Ripto. You're not getting any more orbs if I have my way. And he just grabbed one. Go! Now you gotta watch it with his scepter blasts, because sometimes he'll actually lead his target, so you gotta be careful. Yeah, the green orb attack is a type of chemical attack. Chemical warfare, if you will. The only problem is, the problem with Ripto is that once you get a power-up, he'll know that you've got it, and he'll try to run away, making it harder to hit him. Ooh, right in the butt! Get back here, boy! Alright, phase two. Say hello to Mecha Gulp. Yeah. A robotic version of... Ouch! Oh, come on. Really? I was moving plenty well enough to avoid that. No, that's mine! Ah, you stole it. Gulp, the mechanical gulp isn't much more mobile than Ripto. The problem is Hunter seems to drop the orbs right in front of him so he can grab one. And he's gonna get a power-up, and it is the blue power-up. Now watch this. Avoid the shadows to avoid being blasted. Pretty simple. Just stay still. Only move if you're directly under a shadow. No, I'm not dying. Time to get blasted, boy. You ain't so tough. No! Aw, dang it. Stole it from me, man. Like a thief in the night. Oh my goodness. Red power-up releases a fire dragon that will chase you down. But you can use this to your advantage by making the dragon crash into Gulp. So, yeah, right in front of you, man. You're going down this time. Okay, oh yes, come on, baby. One more hit. One more hit. That's all I ask for. Blast it. No, you're not getting this one. Dang it! Why can't I get that? Laser! Fires a revolving laser. Okay, here we go. Alright, that's the end of the second phase. On to the final part. We're not done yet. Ripto will spawn a robotic bird, and then Spyro will pick up one of the golden orbs, and the final phase begins. And there's no more Hunter this time. He actually crashes. And so it's just you and Ripto now. Let's do this. Now Ripto will fire scepter blasts, and he'll also try to do ramming attacks with his bird, so... yeah, this is definitely a final boss fight. This is a much better final boss than Nasty Nork was. If you ask me, I mean, this is a true boss fight right here. And it's a perfect way to end this project with an epic fight to the finish. Right, he's almost done. Whoa! I almost got run over. Come on, boy. Is this all you've got? Alright, he's almost dead. Here we go. And it is all over! And that is it. The Reign of Terror is over. Ripto defeated.
Enough, Spyro. I suppose you have to go now?
Yeah, I'd better. They'll be missing me in the Dragon Worlds, and I've still got a vacation to take. I need it more than ever now.
Before you go, I think that Moneybags has something he wants to give you.
I most certainly do not.
Hunter? Spyro, Moneybags is very sorry that he made you pay so much on your way through Avalar. We want you to keep the gems as a reward for helping us.
Wow, thanks. Sparks, can you grab them? Let me just type in the new coordinates and... there! Spyro, you can now go to Dragon Shores. Hey, why don't you guys come with me? I bet you could use a holiday.
I'm afraid we can't, Spyro. Ripto may be gone, but he caused a lot of damage during his short stay. We'll be cleaning up for weeks. Just remember, though, that you can always get back to Avalar from Dragon Shores if you want to visit.
Well, okay. Come on, Sparks. We've got a lot of vacation to catch up on.
Man. And there you go, that is it. The final battle against Ripto, and Ripto has been defeated. And now it's time to sit through the credits, much like after defeating Nasty Nork and Spyro 1, so... yeah. Ugh. I need to think about what I'm going to say during these things, because it's just a long period of me doing nothing. So, yeah, that's it. Ripto has been defeated. All the treasure has been gathered, and all the treasure that Moneybags took from us has been given back, so we now officially have all the treasure in the game. All the orbs have been collected, all the talismans have been collected, all the bosses have been beaten, everything is done 100%. But just because Ripto's been defeated doesn't mean this project is over. Oh no. There's still a couple other things to show. In this game, this project isn't completely done. The main game is complete, but there's still a couple more things to do before this Let's Play can be considered fully finished. Those of you that have played this game and have beaten it will probably know what that is. Man, I don't know what it is, but these credits feel like they're taking longer than they took in Spyro 1. I don't know, it just feels slow because that final battle against Ripto was pretty fast-paced, you know? That may be why. I mean, I'd go from all this crazy action to just sitting, doing nothing, you know? But I think I can skip these credits, but I'm not going to. I mean, I've sat through everything else in this game. Why am I going to start skipping stuff now? So I guess, even though this project isn't officially done, I would like to thank everyone that has, you know, followed along and watched it all the way through. I do appreciate those of you that have watched it and have commented and everything. I think this LP's gotten the best reception out of all of my Let's Plays thus far, and I'm very glad I was able to go back and redo this game, much like I did with the original Spyro, because my original Let's Play was done with a camera in front of a TV screen, and I'm glad that, much like Spyro 1, I was able to go back and redo it, and I think this LP turned out better than I thought it was going to, and it got a... As I say, it's probably gotten the best response and reception out of all my Let's Plays thus far. Music by Stuart Copeland. He deserves a lot of credit because his music in the Spyro games is excellent. I think I actually said that during the credits for Spyro 1. So it might not be that much longer before we hit the end of the credits here anyhow, but... So yeah, this project, the project is not officially done yet. There's still one or two other things that have to be done, but the main game, as I said, the main game itself is done. Ripto has already been beaten and everything else has already been done. Thanks to the staff of Universal Interactive Studios. I don't know where I read Sony in there. And that's the credit sequence. And it's on to Dragon Shores. Spyro's been trying to get to here since day one, but now he's finally made it. I think we all could use a vacation, actually.
Well done, Spyro. Step right on into Dragon Shores Park. By the way, if you win 10 tokens, you can visit our theater.
And there it is, the entrance to Dragon Shores Park, the special bonus area for the game. But, as much as I would like to go in there, I'm not going to do that right now. We're going to cut it here. So, That is a wrap on this episode of Let's Play Spyro 2 Ripto's Rage for the PlayStation 1. We have finally defeated Ripto in the final boss fight and have now gathered everything in the game. And stay tuned for the next episode, which will be the finale as we explore Dragon Shores and wrap up this project. See you then. Ultimate Lifeform RB